Hello, namaskar, good afternoon. It's about 3 o'clock now and up at Mahaicony. I'm trying to get some memories. I used to live here between 1975-79. My mother was a dispenser here. And I have some very nice memories, some sad also, some depressive, but some mostly bright, 70% bright. This used to be my regular walkabout to going to school and coming back. Opposite here, you can see opposite is a shop run by Mr. Roberts, I think his name is. Mr. Roberts. Well, this shop, on the first day we arrived, my mother took us by the hand, me and my brother, we went over there. He had some tea biscuits right by this window there, the left window. So we bought some and he gave us some guavas from his yard. It was very sweet guavas, big guavas. My mother said he was a contact here. He would help us. We have any necessities or so. Right around here, the drivers used to be parked. You had people like Bob Skerritt, Mr. Druva, and Mr. Sattar used to be here. The taxi drivers would park here, and they would collect their patients and passengers. Actually, Mr. Bob Skerritt, he came to take us out one night to a jaga or some social function. I can't remember the function name. But my father said, when around it was 11 o'clock, he said that Mr. Bob Skerritt came in his little white Toyota car, short back, like the ladders, the Russian ladders. You know, he came and he took it out. He came for us there. And my father suddenly changed his mind. And he said that he's not going, you know, after some discussion between Bob and my father, Bob Skerritt went away. The next morning, when I wake up, when I heard news, my father's them saying that Bob Skerritt and his wife reached an accident at Mahaicony Bridge, a hit. They drive into a big cotton tree, slam into the tree. Bob Skerritt's wife died. Bob Skerritt was injured terribly, you know. But I used to live here. I noticed they still have the wire fencing. In 1970, when we left, the wire fencing was still there. It had a fencing, wire fences right around. Still there. Here used to be the dispensary. My mom used to work here. This used to be the dispensary area. At that time, the technician was a guy by the name of Mr. John. And I remember this particular dispensary here. Particular dispensary, they had malt. That was the first time I tasted malt. They had a big tin. They used to get malt regularly, black, like chocolate. I used to taste. My mother said they use that for something, make some kind of stuff, you know. But afterwards, I never saw this at any other dispensary. I noticed when I used to be, my mom used to work here, used to be the dispensary. Where I'm pointing, right down there used to be the dispensary. At the corner there you go in, Mr. John was the assistant worker, my mother, tall, strong African guy. At the back here used to be the mortuary. Used to keep the dead. My mother, since she was living here, she had to come down all hours. I don't know why, but she would be the one come sometimes to examine the diseased. She would have to look at them. I would try to go, but she never allowed us. And right behind there at the back, you can see right behind there, the mortuary, they had a dung's tree. I used to go there to pick the dung, but my mother told me not to pick the dung because the mortuary water, they would wash it through some hole or gutter until it's going right there, but the dung was very sweet. Sometimes I would climb up there when my mother would go to spy in the mortuary to see a dead, but I never saw a dead. You know, I never saw the dead there. And used to be in the mortuary right at the back there, but I don't know if it's still the mortuary. And right over here, they had some other officers used to be living. They had the agricultural officer. They had the agricultural officer. And they had Mr. Bob. who was the agriculture officer, and they had another Bob at the back here. He used to live down there. Here, he was kind of like the social worker, but he never mixed too much with us. What I remember is that a green car used to park somewhere around here, green Lanza. That was all I see. His house used to be locked up, curtains, quiet, nothing. He had a child used to take to school, but not anymore. But this used to be the agriculture officer's house. And sometimes we would come over here to play with the children. One of his child become a doctor, Mr. Ronald Ali or Michael Ali, I can't remember his name. He went to Queen's College, did his A-level. And then he went to UG and do his MD. But this used to be our house at the back here, the dispenser house. In these days, they never used to train so much doctors in Guyana, you know. So a dispenser in those days was very highly, you know, appreciated, you know. Maybe once two or three doctors a year, they would send to Cuba for training. For training. Actually, I'm doing this video. I did one last month at the West Demerara Hospital. And they kindly allowed me to film on the outside only. I asked and they said only on the outside I could film. But this used to be our house. We were living right here. Now they have some other structures. This changed so much. There used to be two guava trees at the back there. Big guava tree there and a big one. I used to climb it. And they had a lake, a big lake. One day I jump in, plunge into the lake to swim. And I got caught up all over my skin. So it changed, a lot of changes now. I don't see any guava tree. The fence is still like how it was long ago. I used to, when the house here was there, there was no downstairs. There was just, we used to play underneath the bottom. It wasn't so, part of it was concrete, not all of it. But this was the house I was living in. Very beautiful house. So, I was always intrigued at the back here. At the back here, when I look out through the mesh fence, I usually saw pigeon peas. There used to be growing a lot of pigeon peas beyond this boundary here. I always wondered, we never went out there because the fence was so high. And it always was a mysterious place, you know, at the back here. Never know what was at the back here. We always wanted to know. One day I saw a gray-colored Indian man, dark gray color. He was there looking around, inspecting, working at the back there. Never, he came once or twice, a couple of times. He had pigeon peas he was farming and taking care of the back there. This used to be, I think, Dr. Hari Charan house. I don't know if it's the same building, but right here used to be Dr. Hari Charan. He was Canadian or American or England trained. His family were rice farmers. According to what I heard is that he paid for his own tuition. His family sent him, and they were businessmen, and sent him abroad to study. But when we were living here, he was the doctor, resident doctor here. And he was my mother. They were very good friends. And he had many daughters, but at that time, there had a lot of fencing around here. The fencing, you can't get in. And he had a deer. He was mining a deer. He had a lot of girl children. So this was a very beautiful place for me. This was a place I learned to ride my bicycle. I learned to ride here. One day I saw Mr. Ali, the agriculture officer nearby. His son's with a bicycle. So I told him, let me ride, but I couldn't ride. So I saw they were riding up by the gate, coming down and going back. And I wanted to learn to ride. So they said, okay, jump on the bike. First couple of times they hold me from the seat at the back. Then after that, right from this gate there, just as it is there, just as the gate is right now there. And then after a couple of tries, I started to ride. So, all my days, when school was closed, I spent my Easter, Pagua, Holi, for 3 or 4 years we lived there. And during this time, this was a place Mr. Jim Jones visited also. One day I was home writing his